Where's the fair use?
Excuse me?
Do you know where the fair use is?
Sorry?
Do you know where the fair use is?
Fair use?
Yeah.
No idea.
Do you know where the fair use is?
Sorry, I don't know.
Excuse me, do you know where the fair use is?
So, pardon?
Do you know where the fair use is?
Sorry, no.
Hello, it's Dan Bull. I've been moaning about copyright for years, especially YouTube's content ID system. But incredibly, YouTube have actually invited me to go to their head office to talk to the content ID team about how they can improve content ID for everybody. I'm a bit cynical, I have to say, because I think they might just be trying to lure me in to get rid of me. But let's get on a train and find out where the fair use really is.
Dear YouTube, this here's to you, to tell you that your new rules are poo-poo. I don't know who does your business stuff lately, but it's an understatement that they pissed us off greatly.
I'm at the YouTube space in London now. I've also brought questions that I've got from other YouTubers to ask about content ID. So I've spoken to H2O Delirious. He suggests there needs to be a grace period, like instead of the person that files the claim immediately getting to monetize the content, you have X amount of days to get it cleared up or settled before, then take over monetization. It would stop people from claiming falsely for monetization. NerdCube says, I'd like to ask if they realize how easy it is to fake a takedown. My portal video was flagged by Valve, but that wasn't the real Valve, it was someone abusing the system. Jesse Cox, honestly, I just don't know what to say anymore. It'd be awesome if content ID wasn't automated and we could all actually appeal without having to prove everything ourselves. It's basically guilty until proven innocent, but I'm fairly sure they will never change that. Also, if we're big enough YouTubers without a network, we should have the same protections that networks get when it comes to not being immediately flagged. Total Biscuit spoke to me and said, suggestion-wise, there's two things I can think of. One, hold any claimed ad revenue in escrow until the dispute is resolved, and then give the revenue to the person that won the dispute. Do not automatically give revenue to the person who made it. Two, give YouTubers the opportunity to appeal before the video is taken down, a small window in which they can say, this is clearly a mistake and here is the evidence. Oh, and he's thought of a third point, proper vetting of Google accounts that make takedown claims to ensure they're actually in their rights to do so and not just copyright trolling. I've also got a bunch of different points I've made here about my experience as a professional YouTuber who's had all sorts of issues with it. So hopefully they're gonna listen. Hopefully they'll learn something new from me and I'll learn something new from them. Let's find out. I wasn't allowed to film inside the Google building and was asked not to disclose details of the meeting. So instead, here's some idealized, politically correct stock footage of a typical business meeting. Their insistence on privacy is ironic, considering this is the company that knows more about you than your own mother does.
I've just left the YouTube creator space. I was in a Skype call to America with the guy who actually created the content ID system and implemented it, so he's not the most popular person on the planet, but the good news is he did seem to really be listening to the points I made. I told him all the points that the other YouTubers had said to me and some of the suggestions I had. He was quite honest about the things that they could and couldn't do. I can't go into too much detail about that because I agreed as part of the meeting that I wouldn't. It does seem they are listening, and he was writing or at least pretending to make notes as I was talking, so that's reassuring. One of the main points I was hammering home was, you know, even if content ID is a necessity and has to exist, then at least have a better system of communication from YouTube to creators and from creators to YouTube. Because at the moment, there's no real way for us, the creators, to get in touch with YouTube apart from this automated counterclaim system. And the YouTube aren't really telling us anything. So that's the main thing I said. Look, just tell us what's going on, why things are happening the way they are. That's half the battle. And then obviously the other half is to stop the system being exploited and abused and all these false claims and counterclaims and stuff, and that seems to be the harder part because of the scale of the thing.
A few days after my meeting with the content ID team, YouTube made the announcement that they'd now be holding revenue until any disputes are resolved. This is a great step forward, and if my meeting had any part in making it happen, then I'm off to have a well-deserved wank.
I didn't find a fair use, but I am headed for use term.
This is the winter of our discontent, where Google gives consent for you to nick content from YouTubers too puny to put up a defense. That glued stuck in cement is too tough to prevent.